Tenants East League 2 is where we had our only border derby today down at Milne Town. Unbeaten Langham playing Hoyt Lundeen. Gary Alexander was there and brings us this report.
In the Borders derby between Langham and Hoyt Lundeen at Milne Town, it was a home team who came out convincing winners. A couple of early penalty kicks were missed by the visitors before first half tries from winger Callum Helling and a brace from the hard-running centre Joe Kirkup, together with a Nathan Smith conversion, put Langham 17-0 in front at the break. The Lundeen struggled to get a foothold in the game and made too many mistakes as the home side controlled matters with better game management. 2 minutes into the second period, the try bonus was secured and any slim hopes of a Lundeen comeback were ended with a deft kick through into the in-goal area, which saw winger Lewis Miller win the race to touchdown. Right at the end, replacement Jonathan Wilkes put the icing on the cake as he was on the end of a well-worked overlap to make the final score Langham 29, Hoyt Lundeen 0, and securing 5 East League 2 points for the home team as well as the Neil Rennick Memorial Trophy.
Well, we're obviously quite disappointed with the result. Langham dug deep and managed to get a few scores and missed a couple of penalties early on, which kind of hurt me a wee bit, but just a couple of silly mistakes and getting caught out wide, and we were quite disappointed, but with a few boys missing as well, it's kind of a tough one to take down here, but obviously we've just got to get back training and try and get back working hard again and try and get back sorted for our next home game.
That one means a lot. It's a game that we mark on the calendar early. It's always one to look forward to, local rivals. Been a fixture that's been a bit of heartache for us over the years. They obviously won the league down here and that was a hard one to take, but no, that was everything today. Meant everything to get the win, and especially in the way we did, nailing them, keeping them out, no answer from them at all. So that's what we asked for before the game, and they never got a reply in. Another slow start, which seems to be a thing for us, but once we got into the groove, there was no stopping us. So no, we've got a break next week now, and we'll move on to Berwick after that.
Also in the East League in Division 1, Duns, I'm afraid, didn't do too well. Portobello beating them 59 points to 7, but they were many short and they hope to be back to pretty near full strength for next week. But good news for Earlston, their first win of the season, and it came away from home at Edinburgh Northern by 19 points to 17. We hear now from captain Steve Sesford.
It was hard. It was really hard. They had some big boys. We stuck it to them. Our defence was good. Their attack was really good. Can't fault the boys for their effort. They stuck in and we came away with the results.
And of course, winning on the road as well, a big bonus.
Yep, definitely. Really proud to get that win after two defeats. So the boys are on a high tonight. So hopefully next week we've got Edinburgh Medic. So hopefully we can take it to them as well on the road.
So presumably you got some of your boys back after following injury and unavailability.
Yep, we've got a few boys helping us out as well. So that was really good. Do you know what I mean? Tommy, our top try scorer today, he was outstanding with his feet. Honestly, unbelievable. So yeah, it's good to have these boys coming back and want to play rugby.
You now have a W in the column.
Exactly. So we're all over the moon today. So we just look ahead to next week.